Chek just joined us the last meeting. That means she joined us in April. And she is very courageous, ready to deliver her icebreaker this evening. In the icebreaker speech, she will tell us all about herself. And without further introducing her, I would like to invite Chek Chek to deliver her icebreaker with the title, The Journey.
Hi, good evening.
Good evening. Good evening.
My name is Yong Xin Ting. I am the legal executive working in a construction company. So I always find it strange to introduce myself in this way, because why do I need to introduce myself by my job? It sounds like my name is meaningless. I'm all about my job. So since young, I have been taught to be, why is it we need to be introducing myself to be like, I'm young teaching and I'm a legal executive, because it is accepted way within the society, within the eyes of the society. So since young, my mom has been taught me that maybe you need to study hard, you get a good job, then you go on your career, get married, then you can be safe. So I don't believe that. What I do is on my 13 years old. So I told my mom, Mom, I want to go to the other town to live by myself. She said, why? No girls would do this to herself in this age. So I'm saying that I'm very curious on the world. I want to go for boarding school maybe. So they don't allow. So I pay, because I've been working for during the weekend, maybe 3 to 4 ringgits per day. So I pay for my fee, school fee. I bought the textbook. Then I told my mom, hey mom, I have already done everything. So I want to go to the other town to study. So from there, I start the journey. So I going to the Ramrod Middle School, which is a Chinese school, but which is educated as an English educator. So I went there, I met a lot of different people, I see a lot of different things. I think this is the right choice, because I experienced different things. Of course, I've gone through something unhappy, because along the journey, I was sure feel unhappy sometimes. So I conquered everything by myself. I feel different, but I don't certify. I don't certify by myself. So after my high school, so I decided to go to another town again. So that is Kuching. So I feel like so this is very different worlds from the other town that I went, which is a smaller town compared to the second town that I went to. So I met a lot of different people. I do my college. Although my father has not been allowed, has not allowed me to do that, but I go for work, then I pay for my fee again. So my dad surrendered. So he said, okay, I'll give you a choice. Maybe you can do any course that you want to do. So I've chosen law to be my major. Why do I choose law? Because I think as a person, you need to be respect. Because since young, I feel like girls is, I didn't say mostly, but girls tend to be like less listening by the other people, because there is a society perception in your mind. So I don't believe again, I want to change this. So I study law. I believe in my right. after 5 years being at the second town, so I heard of everybody going to Kuala Lumpur, KL. Oh yeah, I'm from Sarawak actually. So I came to KL, so I feel like I heard of a lot of things. I heard of KL people is hopeless. KL people don't know how is very money-minded. So when I was sitting in the plane, I look at other people. Yeah, okay. They're having a family like a normal person. So nothing is special. So along the way, I spent like 7 years to study my law. I complete the part of my journey. But now I'm an in-house lawyer, but then I'm not certified again. So I continue. I joined Toastmaster. I joined the certified personal trainer for the international training. So I think we shouldn't be stopped on discovering of being who you are. Stop of being of yourself. And stop live in the brain. So what I want to say is that never stop your journey to being who you are. Thank you.